welcome to the channel and to part 3 of the series of videos about vintage chronograph Suisse watch restoration. It is about the well-known Landeron movement caliber 51. Starting from assembling the barrel bridge, lubricating and putting back the crown wheel. When I was working on part 1, I thought that the part 3 would be the final, but then I realized that the video about assembling both movement and chronograph will go too long, and so I decided to dedicate the final part for the chronograph, as it belongs to the special attention in the part 4. So here is the part 3, showing the watch movement servicing. The click spring goes. And the click itself. Putting oil at the point where click and click spring touch each other, and the barrel bridge is ready. Going to assemble the wheel train, starting from main spring barrel and the ratchet wheel. I don't want to forget about putting the setting lever screw. Then goes escape wheel, followed by fourth, third and center wheels. Now barrel bridge could be placed after that. Securing it by two screws but not tightly yet. And starting to assemble the train bridge with the jewel bearings for 3rd, 4th and escape wheels pivots. Here is the click visible from this hole, checking the free rotation of all wheels and securing both bridges by screws. Lubricating all jewel bearings. Now it's time to assemble the dial side of the movement. There is a some engraver of word brevet. I searched online and I just found out that in French it means a government license for making and selling the product. Lubricating center wheel and other jewel bearings on this side. Putting cannon pinion. And lubricating points of keyless work assembly. This is a minute wheel. Yoke goes next. But before putting back the yoke spring, I need to assemble the clutch and setting wheel. Putting some grease on those right now. Thank you. and intermediate wheel following the clutch, and I can put the yoke in place now. Actually, I think I should put yoke now, not before the clutch and setting pinion assembly. And I should put some grease on the touch point between yoke and clutch. And now is the time for the yoke spring. Installing the setting lever, placing the bridge holding all keyless work assembly, preparing the stem to insert into the movement, applying some grease before that. The setting lever is held by setting lever screw that I put from the wheel train side before installing the barrel bridge, and I can secure the setting lever now. Checking the functionality of keyless work assembly. Now going to back to the wheel train side to finish the escapement and balance wheel assemblies. The pallet fork goes first. Then pallet fork bridge. and finally the heart of the watch, the balance wheel. It starts moving and I can secure the balance bridge. There is a lot of improvement from the results that I showed in part 1 before the watch was serviced. And this is all for part 3. Thank you for watching. The part 4 will come soon, where I will assemble the chronograph and complete the servicing by polishing the crystal and the case. Please subscribe and give me likes if you like this video. Thank you again and see you next time. Bye now.